If you know you cannot be able to invest in the hatching, okay, and you cannot go into the grow out, which is growing the big ones, and at least there are still room where you can come over, buy like few kgs, like 10 kg, which are very little money, and open maybe a roadside where you can put a point and kill for people to come, you prepare it, and they can take it from there.
Can you tell us a bit about the urban farming space and why you decided to keep your farm in Accra?
Actually, when I came in, I was just hearing, oh, catfish, akosombo, akosombo. I think my vision was mainly to bring catfish into Accra and at the same time, you know, into respective homes, and which is actually working today. There are so many people who have this pond and the catfish rearing in their homes, even up to 20,000 capacity, like I mentioned.
Wow. Yes.
So they don't go anywhere. They get off on their bed. Very easy. It's just by opening and closing of valve, or scully, will I say valve arrangement. So it does not take much. You can still do other things while, you know, rearing catfish.
What space would you need to be able to fit a pond in your compound?
Okay. Just like I said, that the maximum capacity I have here is 18 by 10 by 4. If you have such space, fine. At least you should be able to take that 1,000 capacity size. But if you don't have that, there are still other sizes. Like we produce based on the customer's demand or request.
Mm-hmm.
We can customize it to the size of space you have available. Okay, but if you have in your home, if you have two plots of land and you built in maybe less than one,
yeah,
and you have about one and left,
mm-hmm,
fine, you could use that one plot that is left to keep over 30 capacity.
30 ponds.
30, yes, 30, yes.
On one plot?
Yes, on one plot of land, yes.
Wow.
Yes.
And FLODAVIK will come help us set up the ponds, make sure we're good. How difficult is it to raise catfish?
It's not difficult to raise catfish. I will tell you that provided once you have the money, the most important thing is to have the money to buy the feed.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have your water. Okay, fine. If you have your water, a good yield of water, because it's one of the things that catfish need.
Consumes
a lot of water. It has to be in a very clean environment.
Mm-hmm.
Or say water management has to be properly, you know, taken care of. Okay, fine. If you have that, you have your feed. Okay. Another thing I advise is training.
Okay.
At least take a training to know exactly what you are into, what you want
to
do there.
Where do we go to learn about catfish training?
Training. Okay. FLODAVIK Ghana Limited will still offer that training.
Nice.
Okay. We train people, both individual and corporate bodies.
Okay.
Fine. And some people, they come alone.
Uh-huh.
We'll take them through the training, at least let them know the importance of the pond, how to maintain it, how to maintain the well, how to do proper water management,
uh-huh,
how to select the right seed, and how to feed the seeds.
So that your catfish won't die.
Yes, so that they will not die. Yes, yes. Okay. This and that is the same.
Okay.
But this is a different size. This is the one, although some here are...
These are huge.
Yes, some here are 3 cedi 50 pesos.
Okay.
Some are 3 cedis.
Mm-hmm.
So if you still buy this within 3 months, you will be able to get 1 kg.
So if you're not patient enough to wait for 7 months,
okay,
you can come.
You can
here,
come over and buy
get a
this.
Thousand of this,
yes,
for 3,000 cedis within 3 months. you can begin to grow or sell.
That's correct.
To the other people.
Yes, and one advantage about this is that the mortality is minimal.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. So you can be able to manage it even if you are a beginner. You can be able to start and manage it properly compared to the 50 per square size. Yes.
Are there more opportunities in the aquaculture industry for young people? Let's say someone who may not necessarily be able to afford a pond. Is there something they can do that can make them returns within a few months if they take it seriously within the supply chain?
Yes, that is just what I just earlier said. Mm-hmm. That if you know you cannot be able to invest in the hatching, okay, and you cannot go into the grow out, which is growing the big ones, and at least there are still room where you can come over, buy like few kgs, like 10 kg, which are very little money, and open maybe a roadside where you can put a point and kill for people to come, you prepare it, and they can take it from there. There are still some people right inside their homes, okay? They will come over, they will buy like 20 kg, keep it in their homes, go internet, inform people what they do. Then those people will do a kind of make an order from them, and they will prepare it in their house and deliver it to that customer. So there are still people doing it. So there are a lot of opportunities, you know, that the youths could go into if you do not have enough money to start. You can start from there, raise funds, and go into a catfish business proper.
So I hope you've been inspired that you can start a catfish business. Literally, if you have about, I don't even know how much, 100 cedis, for instance, you can go to somebody who's a farmer and it's supplying it at 20 cedis. With that 5 catfish, you can grill it and sell it to somebody for 60 cedis, right? That's double the price that you paid for it. You can start your business there. You can buy a fingerling. Is that fingerling?
Fingerlings, yes, or juvenile.
No, you can buy juvenile catfish for less than 1 cedi, grow them for a few months, sell them off for 3 cedis or 3 cedis 50 per square. So there's so many opportunities in the supply chain. And I know a lot of you are now wondering where you can find FLODAVIK so that you can come purchase your catfish. So Mr. Boniface will tell us all about where they can find us so they can start their own businesses in the catfish space.
Thank you. For FLODAVIK, you can reach us on our telephone numbers, 054-7740260 or 0200-771514 or 0302903854. But most often, I will prefer you call this because this one is always handy.
Thank you so much, Mr. Boniface.
Thank you.
For having us here. It's been a pleasure learning about the catfish industry. I'm hopeful because I didn't know that you can just buy for 20 cedis. What happened to the profit margins there? It's like, who decided that they're going to sell catfish first?
Well, that is business.
60 cedis.
For me, I know that is business because even there are a lot to come out of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, some other people will come up with flair, catfish flair, catfish one thing or the other. Yeah, it's just all about, you know, interest and, you know, business creativity.
Wow.
Yeah, so you come up and you place your prize and people admire it.
So any last words for young people who are still asking themselves, what business can I start in this country? I don't have enough money. I don't have any connections. What do you want to tell them?
Anyway, Ajiga, thank you. Farming is the way to go. Catfish business, just like I mentioned, if you cannot be a hatcher, you could still be a grower. It does not stop you, even if you are working. You can as well do it as a part-time business. Feed the fish in the morning. By the time you come back from work, you feed it. It's just two times, and that is enough. You could change your water either in the evening or you change it early in the morning before you go. As you are changing the water, you can as well do whatever you want to do. It can be preparing your breakfast or whatever in tandem and finish up and go. At the end of 6 months, you make your money. Instead of putting that money in the bank, you turn out more money out of it. Okay? If you don't want to work, you could as well use it, at least make yourself self-employed. Okay? But if you cannot, if you do yourself self-employed, you could grow the catfish, you could join it up with, you know, grilling, you could join it up with barbecue, you could join it up with, you know, making lye soup, pepper soup, or whatever. All of these are money making. In fact, you could think of something out of it. But all I have to say is that catfish business is still a virgin land, okay? There is still lots and more to eat. But the most important thing is that try and make your interest and you make a fortune out of it.